Hello everyone, I hope you are doing well. In this video, I am going to discuss about the Goldman Sachs latest exam pattern 2022. So in this video, we will discuss about the selection process, exam pattern, syllabus, total questions, section wise, total time, section wise, will there be any negative marking or not. If there will be any negative marking, then how many marks you will get for correct answers, how many marks will be deducted for incorrect answers, and other things we will discuss in this video. So watch full video for better understanding. Let's get started. So first let me show about this selection process. So this is the Goldman selection process. There will be total 4 rounds. Round 1 will be aptitude test. Aptitude test will be purely MCQ type. Round 2 will be technical test. Please note, once you qualify the round 1, then only you will be eligible for round 2. And round 1 and round 2 will be held on different day. And there will be at least 10 days of gap between round 1 and round 2. Okay, so you will have you will get a lot of time for preparation for round 2 if you clear round 1. But round 1 is difficult. Okay, Goldman Sachs exam is very difficult. Okay, so yeah, round 1. Now round 2. In the round 2, there will be MCQ plus coding type questions. And once you qualify round 2 also, then you will be eligible for technical interview. Once you clear technical interview, then you will be eligible for HR interview. Okay, now let's discuss about each of the round and in detail, and the syllabus and selection process, exam pattern. So round one is aptitude test. So there total will be 66 questions. You need to solve 66 questions in 90 minutes. And in the round one, there will be total 6 different sections. Section one will be numerical computations. In numerical computations, you need to solve 8 questions. And please note, there is not any individual timing. You will have to solve all these sections in 66 minutes. Okay, so there is no individual timing for each of the sections. Okay, so you will have total 90 minutes for these 6 sections. Okay, so yeah, so numerical computation, 8 questions, and question type is MCQ. Second section is numerical reasoning. There will be total 12 questions of numerical reasoning, MCQ type. There will be total 12 questions of logical reasoning, MCQ type. There will be total 12 questions of abstract reasoning, MCQ type. There will be total 12 questions of diagrammatic reasoning, okay, MCQ type. And there will be total 10 questions of verbal comprehension, MCQ type. Okay, and please don't worry, I'll make a separate video on each of the sections from tomorrow. Okay, so tomorrow I'll upload a video on any one of the section, after that on second day, second section, and I'll try to make all these sections as soon as possible. Okay, so you will have best practice. Okay, now yeah, there will be negative marking. For correct answer, you will get 5 marks, and for it incorrect answer, you will lose 2 marks. Okay, now let's talk about the round 2. So round 2 will be technical test. In the technical test, there will be total 38 questions you need to solve in 135 minutes. But here, please note, here there will be an individual timing. Okay, so first round, here in round 2, first section is programming MCQ. So in programming MCQ, you need to solve 20 questions in 30 minutes. Okay, there is individual timing in each of the section. And this section is MCQ type. Second section is aptitude advanced. So here you need to solve 28 questions in 25 minutes. Again, MCQ type. Another is computer science. Here 7 questions you need to solve in 20 minutes. Again, MCQ type. Okay. And another thing is competitive programming. Here you need to solve 1 question in 45 minutes. This is subjective. Okay, another section is subjective writing skills. 2 questions, 15 minutes, subjective. Okay, so please note, here there will be negative marking only for MCQ section, not for subjective. Okay, for subjective there is no negative marking, but for MCQ type question there will be negative marking. Okay, so for incorrect answer, you will your 2 marks will be deducted for each of the incorrect questions, and yeah, and for correct questions you will get 5 marks. Okay, yeah, so this is, now let me tell you, in the programming MCQ, they will ask MCQ based on your data data structure, DBMS, OOPS concept, like this type of questions. And in the computer science also, they will have same kind of questions, but in advanced level. Okay, and aptitude advanced is the same advanced aptitude test, but in advanced level. Okay, and competitive programming is a programming coding question, and this is a difficult level coding question. Okay, and here you need to solve. They may ask a question related to data structure, so please prepare data structure very well. Okay, data structure is very important topic for the coding question of Goldman Sachs. And another thing is subjective writing skill. So in this subjective writing skill, you need to write an essay, but in technical essay, okay, not general essay. They will give you topic of technical essay topic. Okay, so you need to solve. So for total unit you will get 15 minutes, so you can divide the timing 7.5 minutes for one question. Okay, but there is no individual timing. So yeah, so this is the update. Now I'll make a separate video on each of the topic very soon. Okay, from tomorrow I'll start uploading video on each of the topic. Okay, so I'll explain which type of question they will ask in the exam, and I'll solve each of the question. Okay, I'll solve each of the question, which type of question they will ask and how to solve those questions. Okay, so yeah there will be negative marking. And one more thing, you may have doubt, do you need to turn on your camera during the exam? Yes, you need to turn on your camera during the exam. Okay, and I'll make a separate video on what to do, what to not do. Okay, do's and don'ts, I'll make a separate video on that of Goldman Sachs exam. Okay, so don't worry, just subscribe this channel so that you don't miss any important updates. And you can join our Telegram channel, which I'll provide link in the description box. If you think this video is helpful, like this video and subscribe this channel for more such videos. Thank you for watching this video.